let us solve all the questions, you know. So finally, of course, our program, as I told you, with comes with an unlimited validity. All right, so yes, let's discuss quickly all of your questions. Okay, so Yash Jodh says, does extracurricular include sports? Yes, absolutely, Yash Jodh. In past, I've had students getting match. They were good in football, they were good in cricket, they were good in squash. Basically, sports shows your mental agility, team capacity, team building, leadership quality. So these are very, you know, important aspects, because as a resident doctor, you will be part of the team. So they will more than happy to appreciate your interest. Okay. So yes, if you are interested in any sports, you should continue that. They want all-rounded physicians. They are not expecting, you know, people who are just, you know, into books. All right. So those who want these sample mock examinations can email us on usmle@mocksysteem or WhatsApp us on this number, and one of our team members can be in touch with you. Pawan, you can, you know, reach out to our number and they will let you know. Siri, our all classes happen online because at Moksh, students are not only studying from India. We have students studying from Russia, China, Ukraine, Belarus, Europe, everywhere we have students studying, all right? And our faculties are not only from India. So they are from US, Canada, Caribbean, Middle East, all across the globe. So that's why everything is online. So are your exams, okay? And be very careful if you are from Hyderabad, because unfortunately in Hyderabad, there are weird companies, you know, I mean, you will get a shock of life, you know, when you... You hear to what they say, you know, so be very careful. Okay, be very, very careful. That's all I can recommend. You know, we get to hear from, you know, a lot of students. You know, they, I mean, can't even tell you so many stories. So stay safe if you are in Hyderabad and thinking about USMLE. Because all majority of companies are franchisees. They are not even original companies. All right. Absolutely, Pawan Kumar. Pawan Kumar is asking, do Moksh help with US clinical experience and everything? Yes, Pawan Kumar, we are a company which work step by step, module by module. Our international students, in fact, start the course right before joining the medical school. They do something what the American students do, called as a pre-med program. And Indian students do the module 2, which is step 1 and CK preparation, which goes parallel to their medical college. Okay. Module 2 is a 4-year program for students, for interns and graduates. It's a 2-year fast track program, which I showed you on the software. Under module 3, we help you with US clinical experience, clerkships, CS exams, and entire journey with a CV. So you can join us at a different level for different modules. All right. Very good question. How to keep up with college exams and USMLE? Please understand, Rishika, the approach is very simple. In fact, I appreciate, you know, you to ask this question, because, you know, Dr. Wazir Kudrat, you know, our faculty, he has talked very nicely on this part. You should watch his videos, you know, why to start from first year, how to combine medical school students preparation and college. See, understand something. What he says, you know, in his videos, one of the sessions which I have attended, he says life is all about smiles and slaps. So if you are just reading content, watching videos, or attending lectures in class, how will you know, are you ready for the exams or not? The only way to know we are ready for exam is to practice questions. If from the first year you are not habitual to practice USMLE style questions, later on it becomes difficult, all right? So he always says life is all about smile and slap. So if you get, you know, keep on smiling in the initial phase of your life, later on life will slap you. Or if you have slaps in the initial phase of your career, later on, you know, life will slap, you know, smile. So what he meant was, is to solve a lot of questions. So when you say you are in second year, if I were on your place, what I do is I attend the Moksh online sessions. I attend my college. and I try solving these questions from pharmac, patho, you know, whatever subjects, microbio, whatever subjects I am studying right now in second year. Only then I will realize how ready I am. See, understand this, you are not studying only for USMLE. You are studying to gain a degree, you are studying to become a good doctor, you want to become a good patient, you know, a physician. See, very importantly, you guys need to understand that we at Moksh, you know, our theory is a little different. We don't only want you to learn from the aspect that, you know, you have to prepare for an exam. No, we are more focused that you become a patient-centered physician. This is more important for us. Please understand this very, very clearly. Our objective is a little different. We want to create good doctors in India. That is our focus. Not that how and, you know, just getting scores. Because reality is what? The current corona situation has already taught us. But in reality also, you need to know your patient from your patient history, from your multi-system level, organ level, tissue level, cell level, protein level, and finally the DNA level. If you are able to understand the patient from the pathophysiology perspective right up to DNA level, you will be a very good doctor. Wherever you are in your life, whether you are in India or abroad, doesn't matter. That is our focus. What we teach you is that the knowledge of first, second year is equally very, very useful for your career. You might hear from a lot of people that, you know, first, second year is just theory, doesn't matter in life. It does. Your foundations have to be strong, otherwise lot of time miss, you know, judgments. You know, a lot of time people say so-and-so doctor has a very good diagnosing skill, so-and-so is, you know, great for a second opinion. The reason is they go deep in their subject. And that is what we expect our students to do. So what I will advise each one of you who are in first, second year, who are aspiring to also write the next exam, please watch this video. It's a 1 hour, 40 minutes, but it talks about our entire concept of patient-centered learning, which is highly important for you to understand. Pawan Kumar, yes, I am going to talk about next. In fact, I will talk about the next from the application perspective and the procedure perspective. But you should attend Moksh guest sessions where our faculties talk from the knowledge perspective. That is very, very important. Siri, you don't have to worry about the study material. Everything is available, okay? Don't worry about, you know, somebody claiming new edition for 20, new edition for 19. Somebody saying you, oh, you know what, 2017, two chapters were missing. They are there in 2018. Don't go into all of these marketing gimmicks, okay? Understand the simple logic, which means they were cheating the 2017 students. They gave them two chapters less. So don't believe somebody says, oh, now we have new books with a new cover. Only thing changes is cover, nothing else. So don't fall for all of these things, all right? See, understand something. You need to be a good doctor. You need to have a good judgment of content, okay? Don't go by the looks of part of it. Understand what exactly is required. Okay, Yashjot is asking, if you know Spanish, you need to have a certified course. No, Yashjot. Moment you say, I know Spanish, the doctor will start speaking to you in Spanish. That's it. They expect you to know basic level of Spanish and they deal with Spanish patients very regularly. So as long as basic communication you can do in Spanish, that's more than enough. Okay? Don't worry. At Moksh, we will train you for that. You don't have to worry. Okay, Hunar has a question. Is research publication important, or will it work even if you have done a research but it does not get published? So first of all, Hunar, understand, very simple, you cannot ever claim that you have done a research if there is no publication. That it's of no use. I cannot say I'm a doctor if I've taken an admission in a medical school. I cannot say that. My research needs to be published in an index journal which can be found in the Google of research, which is PubMed. Unless I can not find your name here, you cannot claim you have done research. Please understand this very clearly. And importantly, do research only if you are interested to do research. don't do it just because you know somebody else has told you. So if you are seriously passionate about it, go for it, you know, because it definitely adds to your profile, adds to your entire journey. Okay, let me quickly show you an example, you know, because Dr. Daugherty here has given a very good video, especially for Indian students. So I will in fact recommend you to watch this video separately. But more importantly, Hunar, let me know which specialization are you planning to do PG in, because I will tell you, research is important for few specializations, for few it's completely your own choice. So without fail, Hunar, you can watch this video. This video will give you a complete clarity on how important is research. All right, clear? So I'm waiting for your answer, Hunar. All right, internal medicine. So please understand where research is important. Okay, research is important if you are planning to do neurology, pathology, psychiatry, okay, surgery, OBGY, and not medicine directly, but after medicine, if you are planning, let's say, oncology or GI, it does help. Okay, please understand, this is not a thumb rule. Don't go that, okay, don't quote me that I said only these specialization. Usually we have seen for these specializations it is helpful. Okay, yeah, so endocrine, that's what I'm saying. There is no thumb rule, but yes, if you have, it's great. Yes, Pawan Kumar, research. Acha, good you asked this. Pawan Kumar is asking, can research be from India or America? So research, it is from India or America, doesn't matter. Both are valid. Research from India or America, both are valid, but the publication has to be done in an index journal, which is very much linked to PubMed. Please understand this. But clinical rotation has to be only from America. Research can be from anywhere, doesn't matter. Clinical rotation have to be there in my own specialization only. Research can or cannot be in my specialization, no problem. Please understand these basics. A lot of time people get confused. Okay, I hope this is clear for each one of you. Siri, we work very differently. You know, it depends on the module which you go for. So you can contact our counselors. They will let you know how the costing things work and all. Okay, it's very depending on which modules you are going, because we don't compulsory make you do all the modules, only the modules which you require to do. For example, for clinical rotations, we first recommend you to try directly with the universities for the free rotations. That's why we make our students apply for rotations directly to the universities. The reason is very simple. Your profile becomes very strong if you are applying to these big universities where you can do free rotations. Okay, those who have questions regarding rotations, trust me, majority of your doubts will clear with this link. And please listen to my webinar, almost a 2.5 hour webinar I did yesterday. Okay, I'll send you this link. You can watch this link as well, but attend the session which I conducted yesterday. That gives you a clarity. All right. Yeah, Hunar, what I meant is research can be in any specialization. Okay, but clinical rotation have to be in your specialization. So for example, if I want to join OBGY residency, I have to do OBGY, you know, clinical rotation, but I have to show my skills of research. So I can do research in patho. I can do research in any subjects. See, research is something, is an opportunity which you got during your med school. It can be irrespective of the specialization. So don't worry about that. All right.